Earlier, we talked about how whenever we have a system of linear equations, if we try to solve that, we can kind of turn it into a augmented matrix. So if we have a system of linear equations, whenever we want to solve that, we can turn it into a net matrix. So there is some relationship between the system of linear equation and matrix. In this example, we're going to talk about how vector fit into all this stuff. So in this example 3.5, we're going to talk about how vector translate into system of linear equation. And in the next example, we're going to talk about how vector translate into the matrix properties of a matrix as well. So for example, if I want to solve this system of linear equation, notice that, well, I can actually turn this into a vector equation by just writing it as a vector x plus 2y, 3x minus y, and then x has to equal to 7, 0, 1. However, for the left-hand side, I can actually rewrite this vector as x, 3x, and x plus 2y, negative y, and then 0. This guy has to equal to 7, 0, 1. Yeah, so I can rewrite this system of equation into this matrix equation, I mean this vector equation. However, if I pull out the common factor, which is x here, I'm gonna have 1, 3, 1 times x plus, if I pull out y from the second vector, I'm gonna have 2, negative 1, 0 times y. This has to equal to 7, 0, 1. But if we look closely at this equation, this is basically asking if the vector 7, 0, 1 is a linear combination. A linear combination of the other two vectors. Is this guy a linear combination of 1, 3, 1 and the 2, negative 1, 0? Yeah, if 7, 0, 1 is a linear combination of these two vectors, then that means I can find x and y that satisfy this equation. However, if it's not, then that means I cannot find x and y here. And in fact, we have seen from the earlier example, 3.2, that indeed, this vector 7, 0, 1 is a linear combination of these two vectors. So that means I can find a solution for sure. And indeed, the solution is going to be x equal to 3 and y equal to 2. So what this essentially means is that whenever we try to solve a system of linear equations, we can actually kind of translate that into solving a linear combination problem instead. So in a way, solving a system of linear equations. This is basically the same task as solving a linear combination problem. In other words, if something is a linear combination of some set of vectors, then that something is going to have to belong to the span of those vectors. And if we have a system of linear equation written in matrix equation form like this, then that means I can find a solution to this system of equation, kind of like what we have here. Now for part B, well, this is actually the same thing. This is basically asking if 1, 2, 3, I'm just basically going to go ahead and copy and paste what we have here. This is basically asking if the vector on the right hand side, which is 1, 2, 3, is this guy a linear combination of the coefficients of x and the coefficient of y. And the coefficient of x is going to be 1, 3, 1, kind of like what we have here. And then the coefficient for y is going to be 2, negative 1, and 0, like what we have here. And we have seen earlier that, well, this vector 1, 2, 3 is not a linear combination of these two vectors. And that means I cannot find x and y that satisfy this equation. So, no, this is not a linear combination. And what that means is there will be no solution to this system of equation. So there will be no solution. For the next one, well, this is actually the same thing. This is the same as asking if the vector that we have here, negative 1, negative 1, and 2, the right-hand side, is a linear combination of the other two vectors. So I'm gonna have negative 1, negative 1, and 2. And we have seen in the last example that in fact this is not a linear combination of the two vectors. So there will be no solution to this system. So no solution here. And for the last one, well, we actually kind of already solved this in the previous lecture. We have done this in example 2.1 part D. This guy, even though we don't know the value of ABC, this is always solvable. This is always solvable. And what that kind of means is the vector on the right hand side here, the vector ABC, this is always going to be a linear combination, is a linear combination of the coefficient vector that I have on the right hand side. So if I were to look at it, the coefficient of x, that's going to be 132, and then the coefficient for y, that's going to be 295. The coefficient for x1, x2, for x3, that's going to be 1, negative 3, and 0. And the coefficient for x4 is going to be 3, 0, and 7. 3, 1, and 7. 3, 1, and 7. Yeah. So no matter what the values of A, B, and C are, I can guarantee for sure that this guy is going to be a linear combination of this four vector. And that's because this equation is always going to be solvable. But if we look at this again, because ABC can be anything, so in fact what that means is every vector in R cube. Yeah, so that means I can write every vector in R cube as the sum like vector ABC here. So what that means is every vector in R cube is a linear combination of these four vectors that we have from earlier. So let me just copy and paste that here. Yeah, so I can conclude from the fact that this guy is always solvable, that every vector in R cube is going to be a linear combination of these four vectors. In other words, what that means is the span of the four vectors that we have here, the span of the four vectors that we have here is going to be R cube. Yeah, so if I span out these four vectors, that's going to give me all the possible vectors in R cube. We're going to explore this situation in the next example here.